none like it in all of baseball. A look at AT&T Park in San Francisco. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the AL West leading Houston Astros and the Giants. Matt Vasgersian here with you. Welcome to Giants Baseball. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, ought to be a decent pitching matchup here this afternoon.
Well, there you see the numbers on them right there. And they're going to have to beware out there because both teams like to run quite a bit. So keeping their opponents off base and keeping that running game in check could turn out to have a big influence on this ballgame.
Jose Altuve will step to the plate now as we're ready to get this one underway. Hard hit towards center. Blanco is there, and he has it for the first out. So Altuve unable to reach to start things out. And with that, let's take a look at the defense for the San Francisco Giants. It's brought to us by the folks at Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. The pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out. Number one will step in now. Stepping in now, number one. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Eric Karros, this Giant ball club, as they begin play here this afternoon, they come in a bit of a rough patch. They've dropped four in a row.
And you know, the little things have been a recurring theme on these telecasts for years now, but when you're in a losing streak like this...
And now we'll see what the Giants can do. No score. Marwin Gonzalez is going to come on as a defensive replacement now as he takes over at first base. Here now is Nori Aoki to start things out in the home half of inning number one. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1. Pitch on the way. Grounded foul toward the third base dugout. Now the pitch. Goes the other way as this is lined to left. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Well, that's one of the dangers of being a corner outfielder. If you dive, there's no safety net behind you. I think he's pretty lucky in the end that this one wound up only being two bases instead of three. Heck, could have even been four.
In now, Matt Duffy. Now a ball hit hard towards center. And that's in there. Base hit. Around third now is Aoki. On Blasmus has thrown him out at home plate. And on the play, the runner moves into scoring position now at second.
Boy, this was lining up to be a close play. It's a base hit, and he comes up throwing. And if this ball's offline by a foot or two, I think he's in there. Instead, it is right on the money, and they nail him trying to score.
Here's Buster Posey now as he takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He'll enter play with that average at a sterling 331. 16 homers and 71 runs batted in. Now the 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. He waits. Now the pitch. Swung right over the top of that one as this is a little dribbler out in front of the mound. On to first, and there are two down.
Yeah, and that's not always an easy play for a pitcher, especially when he has to barehand the ball. But luckily, he's got plenty of time out there, so he's able to set himself and then make a good, strong throw.
Pause, now the pitch. And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One left for San Francisco. We've played an inning. No score. Here's Jed Lowrie now. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. 264 is average entering play. Four home runs, 13 RBIs. Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Another 0-2 home. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2. Now the pitch. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called. One away. Here's the center fielder now, Colby Rasmus. As he will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. On the first, and a good stretch over there is going to get him by a step for the second out. Evan Gattis now standing in. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. That batting average hovering in the high 230s. 16 homers and 59 RBIs. Now a grounder foul wide of Belt down at first. Here's the pitch. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Astros. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Here's the first baseman, Brandon Belt. As this is grounded foul off to the left, it's strike one. Here it comes. Good hard sinker swung on and missed. 0-2. You have to figure that sinker is going to be an important pitch for him here this afternoon.
No question about it. Obviously, it's his ground ball pitch, so if you're a hitter, you're going to need to make him bring that pitch up.
And no chance on the throw, so a great effort, but that'll be scored a base hit. Here's the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. Looking to bunt here, but he can't connect, and that's the first strike.
And they did have the bunt on right there, so now 0-1. You wonder if they're going to do it again.
Now a ball grounded sharply, but this is foul past Lowrie over at third. From the belt, the pitch. Now he runs up and gets this one down. On to first, and it's dropped. And now there'll be two on with nobody out.
I want you to watch this throw here. You know, this isn't in the dirt. It's not in the sun. It's right there. But he just drops it. No real explanation. Just a bad error.
He's set. Now the pitch.
Down. 0-2.
In the dirt here. But fortunately here, no advance. He's ready. Now the pitch. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. Standing in now, Aure Adrianza. Out in front as this is in the air toward deep right field. Number 20 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out. Into the box now, Chris Heston. And now a ball lifted into the air out toward center field. And Rasmus will put this one away, and that ends the inning. Giants leave a couple. We'll move to the third with no score. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. He comes in at 262 on the year. Seven homers and 22 RBIs. Here's a swing and a little tapper in front of the mound. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. As he'll swing and lift a foul ball off to the left and out of play. Now here it comes. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
Swing and a shot back up the middle. And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
Wow. Watch the reaction here in show motion after this ball is hit. Pitchers have nightmares about balls coming back like this, and this one nearly on Gressman's rocketed into center field. That could have really been trouble.
Well, it's worth remembering that here in the American League, guys aren't really asked to bunt the ball all that often. No excuse for popping this one up, but this not quite as commonplace as it is over in the National League.
Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short.
Oh, look at this!
And from the seat of his pants, he gets the force at second. What a play to retire the side. One for the highlight reel as they get the force play to get him out of trouble. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Here's Nori Aoki. First pitch of the inning here is wrapped right back from where it came, and that'll get into center field for a leadoff single. Stepping in now, Matt Duffy. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. This one into center for a base hit. And they keep rolling here. Their runners at the corners with still nobody out. Here's Buster Posey now, as he'll go after the first pitch and send a ground ball down to third. On to first, and it's a double play, although the run does come into score from third.
Well, I think it's always disappointing when you have a first and third situation and hit into a double play, but at least you do get that first run on the board, so they get their starter the early lead.
Here's the right fielder, Hunter Pence. He'll pop this one foul off to the left, and it's strike one. Now here's the pitch. Curveball hit on the ground to shortstop. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. Two hits for the Giants lead to a run in the inning. Three innings complete. Giants on top, 1-0. In now, number 20. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Now here's the pitch. It goes the other way as this is hit well out toward deep left field. There for it, Aoki, and he'll make the play for the first down.
And you know, pitching's a lot more than just velocity. You know, this guy, he's living proof. If you hit your spots, change speeds, you can get guys out with an 87, 88 mile an hour fastball, and he did it right there.
And the pitch. And now we'll try to bunt for a base hit here as he gets this one down. And Posey's able to get him at first, and the bunt for hit attempt is foiled.
Well, just from a distance standpoint, you have to remember that left-handed hitters maybe get a step or two advantage over a right-handed hitter leaving that batter's box. So that's why it's much easier for lefties to bunt their way on than it is for righties to do it. And here, he needed those two extra steps because that was a very close play down there at first.
Here's the 1-1. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2.
Nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Now another 1-2. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Now the pitch. This is a foul ball.
That ball's foul.
Now another 2-2. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
And this guy won't lay down here because there's two outs and nobody on.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Astros go down 1-2-3. They trail this one 1-0. Here's the first baseman, Brandon Belt, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Here's the pitch. This is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a ground ball, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Now here it comes. Caught off at the plate as it's chopped foul. The next 0-2. Now a ball hit hard towards the hole. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Well, even when you keep him in the ballpark, he can be trouble. Here he's right on this pitch, and he smokes it into left field for a solid single.
Line hard, deep into left. Able to make the play is Gattis, and that's the first out. Here's the lefty, Gregor Blanco, now. As he's swinging first pitch and sends a line drive out to left center. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. Around third, Belt heading for the plate. And the runner will score from first. And he will pull into third with an RBI triple.
Yeah, and no matter how many of these you see in your lifetime, this is still one of the most exciting plays in all of baseball. You can see he's not stopping rounding second base, and he makes it all the way to third there with an RBI triple.
Into the box, Eury Adrianza. Swung on and taken the opposite way out toward deep left center. Catch is made deep in the alley, and here comes the runner from third. And he'll make it in to score. It's a sack fly and an RBI, and it's now a 3-0 ball game.
Good work there to pick up that second run of the inning. He just gets the ball airborne, and it's plenty deep enough to pick up the RBI.
Standing in now, Chris Heston, as he gets under the first pitch and sends a fly ball out toward right field. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. On to the top of inning number five we go. It's the Giants 3 and the Astros nothing. Here's the center fielder now, Colby Rasmus. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a miss here, and he's behind in the count now, 0-2.
Oh, just a little overanxious right there. I guess he figured he had a pretty good gauge on that fastball, and he hoped he'd see it again, but he got the curveball instead.
But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. Evan Gattis now standing in, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location, right on the knees.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
Good changeup right there, down in the strike zone. Definitely the one they wanted to strike him out on, so that's a great job to lay off.
And that's by him into right field for a base hit. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now, as he'll swing and hit this one hard but foul off to the left and out of play. From the stretch. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. And that's through into right field for a base hit. Pence able to get it quickly into the infield, and as a result, that'll hold the runner at third base. Jason Castro, the catcher, is in, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
kind of interesting to see how he's going to respond to this situation that he's worked himself into.
Yeah, he hasn't found himself in too many tough spots, but he's got one now.
Big breaking ball and a beauty that time, 1-2.
Now with two strikes, he can put the ground ball on the back burner and really go after the strikeout.
Oh, and he struck him out. A big strikeout there with the bases loaded, and that's the first out of the inning. Into the box now, Scott Feldman. So weighed out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one. Has a look, now the pitch. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball.
And this is all about having faith in your catcher that he's going to block that pitch as well he should. He's one of the best around when it comes to smothering balls in the dirt.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. No runs, four hits. One error so far for the Astros. Swinging a ground ball towards the middle to Crawford for one. On to Belt, and they turn the double play. That ends the inning. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Here's Nori Aoki. As he's first pitch swinging here, and this is on the ground toward the hole. And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard.
And he's got to be feeling pretty good about this afternoon so far. That's three at-bats, three base hits.
In now, Matt Duffy. And he's going to lay one down here, and it looks like it'll be a good one. Throw on to first, so the sacrifice is successful.
Well, that's pretty good technique right there, and sometimes we just don't see that often enough. Nice and soft, just like he's trying to catch the ball with his bat. And he's able to get this one down and move the runner.
But that'll hit off the wall in left center. Around third now is Aoki. And a relay to the plate. And the ball will come across to score from second, and they open it up to 4-0 now.
Well, that's what he's done well all season. That's swing the bat with runners in scoring position. He drives in another one here on the RBI double.
Number 35 will be the new pitcher. Here's the right fielder, Hunter Pence, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Now some action out in the Houston bullpen, as it appears both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. Big swing and a miss at the changeup, a ball and a strike.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch, and they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
Here comes the 1-1. Big breaking ball and a beauty, 1-2.
Good curveball right there, and that just really froze him.
Now the 1-2. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out. Here's the first baseman, Brandon Belt, as he'll swing and lift a foul ball off to the left and out of play. He's ready now, the pitch. One strike pitch is a fastball high, and that evens things at one. One on the way. Hit hard but foul off toward the dugout. Here comes a 1-2. And here's a ball hit in the air. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. We'll try again, 1-2. And a swing and a miss, as all he could do was reach out in vain for that one, and the side is retired. One for the Giants here on the Buster Posey double. Through five innings, it's now 4-0 San Francisco. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Here's a ball fought off, foul off to the right. It's strike one. And now a pitch on the way. Hit hard on the ground to short. And they will get... No, he's in there. A very close play at first.
Oh, but look here. The manager's up and out of the dugout, so it appears he might opt to challenge that last safe call at first.
Well, here's another look at it now. I couldn't really tell when we saw it live, and I'll tell you what, it's still tough to tell from that angle. We're gonna have to see what the dugout decides.
So here's the signal from the bench, and they will indeed ask for the play to be reviewed. So the umpires will get on the horn with the replay operations center in Manhattan and attempt to get a definitive answer on this play.
All right, so here's one final look at it. Now remember, there has to be indisputable video evidence in order to overturn the call. Now the ruling on the field is safe, and it probably could go either way, but I don't think there's enough right here to overturn this call and call him out.
And a high strike to begin the at-bat, it's 0-1.
0-2.
Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
All right, leadoff man on first. Here's where you gotta start clawing your way back into this ballgame. It's not too late, but it needs to start happening soon.
Number one will step in. He's 0-2 to this point. Stepping in now, number one. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Comes set, now the pitch. And a curveball's in there, so he's quickly behind, nothing and two.
He just might be up there taking pitches, waiting for that base runner to go, but not going to be able to take anymore.
And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off, one and two. And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. Here's Jed Lowrie now, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. He's set, now the pitch. Now the 0-1 is swung on and lifted out to straightaway center field. Blanco is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Astros leave one. They trail here 4-0. Here's the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. Swing and a liner towards second. Oh, and he misses it. And the recovery won't be in time as he'll beat the throw to first.
And when things are going well, these are the little things that just seem to start going your way. Nothing too amazing here, but this winds up an infield single, and the breaks just keep going their way.
Here's the lefty, Gregor Blanco, now. Now he squares and drops down a good one. And they're not going to have a play on him as the catcher just eats it.
Not sure if there was some indecision on where to go with the bunt or what, but it looked like he just thought he had more time than he really did. And throw to first, too late.
Into the box, Eury Adrianza, as he swings and misses at a first pitch fastball, 0-1.
Now with two on, nobody out, you got to be thinking strikeout double play out there on the mound. One or the other is what you really need.
Runs up to bunt here, and it's a good one to the right side. Flip to the second baseman covering now for the out.
I don't think you can ask for a whole lot more right here. You get back-to-back singles, then a good sacrifice, and just like that, they're set up for what could be a big inning.
Chris Heston is in for the third time as he looks at a ball high. It's 1-0.
Very tempting up there, but that's also a pitch that a lot of guys will pop up. So that's a nice job of laying off.
Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground.
He's out.
In time to first, and there are two away.
Yeah, and that's a good job here to get off the mound quickly, pounce on it, and then make a good strong throw.
Here's Nori Aoki. And a bouncing ball, foul. Comes set, now the pitch. And this is hit sharply on the ground toward the hole. And now he has some trouble with it in left. One run is in, throw comes to second. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and no one left. We're through six full. Giants out in front here, 6-0. Back here in San Francisco, Giants leading this one as we get set for the seventh, but before it gets underway, there you see our game summary through the first six innings of play. Here's the center fielder now, Colby Rasmus, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Here it comes. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. And the pitch. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ballgame. Evan Gattis now standing in. And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. And this is fouled back and out of play. No runs, five hits, one error so far for the Astros. He's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ballgame. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now. As he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1.
Boy, he may strike out the side on 9 pitches. 7 down, 2 to go.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. The pitch. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They still find themselves down 6-0. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Pat Neshek will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Standing in now, Matt Duffy. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And that ball is gone. Blasted into the bleachers in left. A solo shot here to left. Number 10 for him on the year as this lead swells to 7-0.
This for a welcome to the ball game. One pitch and see you later. I've got a feeling that's not what the manager had in mind.
Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Here's Buster Posey now. And quick wrists here as this is yanked down the third base line. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller, the thought is that you've got to get out there and hit the ball before it sinks. So that means if you're a right-handed hitter, you've got to jump out there and pull it. And that's exactly what he did.
Here's the right fielder, Hunter Pence, as he'll get out ahead of a changeup and swing through it for strike one. This crowd, likely in the 40,000 range, they've got to like what they've seen so far.
And it's been a complete performance. They need to find a way to bottle this up and keep it going.
Back to first, and that'll take care of Pence. He's gone on the double play.
Well, the one thing this guy definitely has coming in out of the bullpen is that hard sinking fastball. And here it is in all its glory as he gets the big double play ball to take away the pressure.
Brandon Belt stands in as he can't connect here, 0-1.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Now a swing and a ball grounded to second. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Giants add on one more. Bye bye, baby, the solo home run. We'll march on to the eighth. It's the Giants 7 and the Astros nothing. Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. As he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch, it's strike one. Any surprise that this man here is back out there for an eighth inning of work?
Yeah, a little bit to me. I mean, you have the big lead. He's done his job. I thank the guy, pat him on the back, and say, hey, you did a great job out there. Now go hit the showers.
And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far. Here's Carlos Gomez. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Now the pitch. Ball swung on and lifted in the air with some carry out towards left center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch, something to get a base runner and get that guy something else to think about out there.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Slider is in there, and now it's 1-2.
He's closing in on putting up yet another zero.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here he comes on 2-2. Hit high but foul, as that'll get in amongst the fans. The 2-2 one more time. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away. Number 20 would be next. And this is pulled foul, as he was way out in front there. Here's the full count offering. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Worth a second look here, as this is a beauty to end the inning. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Here's the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. Oh, and this one has hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder. And it'll stay in the park as it hits high off the right field wall. And the home half of the eighth starts with a leadoff double. Here's the lefty, Gregor Blanco, now. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. Ready? Now the pitch. Boy, he comes back with a beautiful pitch there, and he's dominating this at-bat. It's 0-2 now. Where do you think they go from here?
I maybe double up and go back to another off-speed pitch. Didn't handle that one all too well.
Now here's a little tapper down that third base line, and this could be a tough play. But a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. A ball hit hard to the left side. But there to take it is Lowry, as he was well positioned for route number one. In now, Eury Adrianza. As he'll get caught chasing a bad one there at strike one. From the stretch. And this is drifting foul back into the stands. From the belt, the pitch. And good contact there, as this is hit high and deep to right center. And this is run down out there in right center as the runner tags from second. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. Stepping in now, Chris Heston. As with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1.
There's not a whole lot of conviction in that swing. It was almost like an afterthought, like an emergency hack.
He's ready now, the pitch. And I'm not sure, but it looks like he may have been blindfolded for that swing. It's 0-2 now.
I'll tell you what, it's tough to try and outthink this guy out there. Seems like whatever pitch he throws, you're stuck looking for something else.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. We've played 8 full. San Francisco leads this one 7-0. Into the box, number 20. 9th inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a cold strike.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got 2 strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
Off the plate, 1 ball, 1 strike. Now a swing and a fly ball hit fairly well out to deep center field. And not the start they were hoping for as the leadoff man is kept off base to start the 9th. Number 1 will try again. 0-for-3 with a strikeout thus far. Into the box now, number 1. Yes, he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. Now a ball hit hard toward first. Oh, and he misses it. And the recovery's too late as he's able to beat the throw to first.
Not to make excuses here, but sometimes when you play behind a pitcher that strikes out a lot of guys, you can get a little flat-footed out there if you're not involved in the action. And here, he just doesn't look this one into the glove, and they'll hit him with an error.
Here's a hard-hit ball back up the middle. On to first, and he rolls the double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout this game. He was completely in charge, essentially, from pitch 1. And now he finishes off a masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory.